The Sun has seen everything come into existence in the solar system. It has seen the birth of our planet and our moon. It lies evidence to the rise of great species and their demise. It has seen kingdoms rise, empires fall, countries being chalked into existence on the world map. It is the only evidence of every lover's promise and every child's cooing. In the cosmic scheme of things, the Sun is the sole spectator of the origin of life on Earth, and when our calling comes, it will be there then too, watching our planet turn into ash. We are because the Sun is. Orbit. Beyond the blue. The Sun has been very active lately, which could cause a few problems for us here on Earth, according to NASA. While the solar cycle is not yet at its peak, the space agency said that activity has already surpassed predictions. Solar flares and eruptions will likely increase from now until 2025, as we reach solar maximum, writes Nicola Fox, the director of NASA's Heliophysics Division. During the Sun's natural 11-year cycle, the Sun shifts from relatively calm to stormy, then back again. At its most active, called solar maximum, the Sun is freckled with sunspots and its magnetic poles reverse. That sort of solar activity has impacts here on Earth. Just before noon on 1 September, two English amateur astronomers, Richard Christopher Carrington and Richard Hodgson, independently recorded the earliest observations of a solar flare. Because of a geomagnetic solar flare effect, observed in the Kew Observatory magnetometer, and a geomagnetic storm observed the following day, Carrington suspected a solar-terrestrial interaction to occur soon. And he was right. On 2 September 1859, one of the largest geomagnetic storms, as recorded by ground-based magnetometers, occurred. An X-level geomagnetic storm, that is 10 times stronger than anything we have experienced so far. Perhaps, until now. 163 years later, we are now faced with another X-level solar flare. Strong solar flares, which are basically intense bursts of radiation, could also create health risks for astronauts, issues for spacecraft, and potentially create concerns about the health of flight crews and passengers on airplanes. The Carrington event, as it came to be known, was the most intense geomagnetic storm in recorded history, peaking from 1 to the 2nd of September 1859 during solar cycle 10. It created strong auroral displays that were reported globally and caused sparking, and even fires in multiple telegraph stations. The geomagnetic storm was most likely the result of a coronal mass ejection from the Sun colliding with Earth's magnetosphere. The Carrington event took place a few months before the solar maximum, a period of elevated solar activity, of solar cycle 10. A geomagnetic storm of this magnitude occurring today would cause widespread electrical disruptions, blackouts, and damage due to extended outages of the electrical power grid. On October 2, 2022, the Sun emitted a strong solar flare. NASA's Solar Dynamics Observatory, which watches the Sun constantly, captured an image of the event. This flare was found to be an X1 flare. One of the most intense flares. Once again, 163 years later, we're heading towards the solar maximum, a time when solar flares are at their most frequent, strong, and potentially catastrophic if they hit Earth. But even before we get there, the last few months have exceeded predictions of the Sun's hot wrath, and occasionally, SpaceX satellites have been falling out of the sky as a result. As we become increasingly reliant on technology and satellites which are less protected from solar activity, such events could be even more troubling. The X1 solar flare might have disrupted Hurricane Ian disaster response. The radio blackout, classed by NOAA as R3, likely affected rescue workers using 25 MHz radios to communicate. The disruption in the upper layers of Earth's atmosphere caused by the flare may also have disrupted some GPS positioning. A somewhat milder flare followed a few hours later, causing another radio blackout over the Western Pacific and Australia. Both flares originated from Sunspot. A darkened area of intense magnetic activity on the sun's surface. The sunspot, called AR3110 in the northwestern part of the sun's visible disk, was accompanied by a coronal mass ejection, which is a burst of magnetized particles from the sun's upper atmosphere, the corona. The two plasma clouds may now be heading to Earth, following a couple of earlier CMEs that exploded from the sun earlier. Simultaneously, a stronger than usual solar wind, a stream of charged particles constantly emanating from the sun, is currently blowing toward our planet from a coronal hole, an opening in the magnetic field of the sun. The combination means that the CMEs may trigger a noticeable geomagnetic storm on Earth in the coming days. In August 2022, satellites detected an explosion on the sun and a long-lasting eruption of a C9.3 class solar flare. NASA's Solar Dynamics Observatory saw hot debris flying away from the blast site. Earth is not in the line of fire. The explosion is significant because it may herald an active region set to emerge over the sun's northeastern limb. While we'll likely see more solar flares, and resulting complications, as we approach 2025, there's no need to fear a doomsday scenario. Some people worry that a gigantic killer solar flare could hurl enough energy to destroy Earth, but this is not actually possible, NASA clarified in a statement. Plus, solar cycles repeat every 11 years. That means anyone over the age of 11 has already lived through a solar maximum, and probably didn't notice its occurrence. Even though the sun is at the center of our solar system, it nevertheless hides many secrets from science. Uncovering these riddles could provide insight into mysterious activities observed in other stars, and potentially provide us with priceless information. It is our curiosity which has led us to send numerous missions to understand the dynamics of one of the largest stars in the universe. The Solar Orbiter spacecraft is our attempt to get to know the sun a little better. This spacecraft is a satellite jointly developed by the European Space Agency and NASA, to observe the sun. It is designed to procure detailed measurements of the sun's heliosphere and also observe its polar regions. On most days, our generally placid sun goes about its job, providing a consistent and predictable quantity of heat and light to keep our planet and its inhabitants alive. But, as we enter the 25th solar cycle, things will get hotter, literally. Just as the sun is responsible for weather on Earth, solar activity can also be responsible for disturbances in our space environment and atmosphere. We need to keep an eye out on these disturbances as they may someday affect us, but what do I know? Orbit. Beyond the blue.